in terms of influenza vaccination. If we can get enough people immunized against the flu in a community, then that lessens the chance of other people within that community contracting and having a flu illness. So the same thought is true with COVID, herd immunity. At this time, we don't have a vaccine, so it would mostly relate to how many people have contracted and recovered from COVID. Because this is such a new virus, we don't really know who's going to be immune and for how long. And so that's the other continued push to develop a vaccine. It may very much be like the seasonal flu virus, where it changes slightly from year to year. We may have a increase in antibodies while we're exposed to that vaccine. And then over time, those antibodies start to taper off naturally because we don't have that repeat exposure. But then again, we know that things like chickenpox cause a very large immune response in the body, and those antibodies stick around for a long time. What we're seeing out of studies is that the more mild the symptoms are, the more quickly those antibodies drop off. What we don't know is what level of antibodies is needed by the body to maintain that immunity. So it may be a very small amount, or it may need to be a very large amount. If it needs to be a large amount, that would kind of necessitate the thought that we would need to have a COVID vaccination every year.